This video contains the clearest walkthrough of the Floyd Warshall algorithm, showing every step to find the shortest paths between all of the pairs of nodes in the graph. Each step is explained with simple graphics, and then each step is shown in Python code. Now, we've made it simple so it's easy to see the inner workings of the Floyd Warshall algorithm. Now, we've used a common network in many of these videos, so we'll continue with this graph. We'll draw the nodes and the connection to the nodes to make it easier to see what's happening. So we're using costs from one node to another. Now, we've already introduced an adjacency matrix, but you can see here the costs. So node 1 goes to node 2 is a cost of 3, as you can see in the table. Node 1 to node 4, cost of 2, same. Node 1 to node 3, cost of 4. We do this with each of the nodes, and you can see in the adjacency matrix the costs. Now, we've already got this adjacency matrix for this graph. We can see here in previous code, when you have a node to itself, it's going to have a value of 0, a cost of 0. So we can see here, we've got the graph to the left and the adjacency matrix to the right. You could see, we're going to correct, we have these zeros when we go from a node to itself. So we've colored them here in red, you can see. And the other zeros, we're going to change to infinity because that's how we're going to apply the algorithm. So we start off with the beginning, just the costs that we know from each node. And then we're going to update the adjacency matrix as we go through the algorithm. So let's have a look at every stage. So we start off from node 1. We can see if we go to node 4, we can update it from infinity to the value 5. So that's less. 5 is less than infinity. We carry on from node 1 to node 4. We have a cost of 4. It was 5 before, now it's updated to 4. So we go through each of the nodes and we update where we have a cheaper cost. You could look at the adjacency matrix. In green, we have the cost that's changed. We go through all of the nodes and we can see the cheaper costs. So for example, here we go from node 1 to node 6. Through this route, at the moment, the cheapest cost is 9 because it's less than infinity. Although we may need to update that again. Let's see. So we're going through all of the nodes, all of the path of the nodes to update the adjacency matrix. Going through each stage, you can see in green the updated cost, which is lower than the cost previously. We go through all of our options. You can see we're updating all of the values, all of the costs, and we end up with the shortest paths between all pairs of nodes. There is a great new opportunity for anyone interested in learning about Python or any other areas of computing. In the next year, new courses will be added to the ALPS Academy, and they will be available to you for free. Written by university professors, they will be specifically designed for international students, which means they'll be easy to understand using simple language. They will even be helped to improve your English, if you're interested. How can this help you? Well, leave a comment. Any suggestions you make could be turned into a course. Motivated learners deserve equal access to opportunities. Help us to help you. Shall we look at some Python code? We look at online code first. We can see first source has quite a lot of comments. Second source, similar functions of the algorithm, how to print, and a matrix. The matrix is going to be the answer. So when we run the code, essentially we just update a matrix and that's the output. Second example, the same. You can see we have the matrix, you have loops in the algorithm, and the output is the solution. Now we've seen some online code, but actually the algorithm is quite simple. We've stripped it down to the most simple form. We have three for loops, each within its side. So inner loop, another inner for loop. And then we just compare the cost. So if we find a cheaper cost, then we can update this adjacency matrix. So we start off, we have six vertices. We create this list of lists with the costs, 0 from node 1 to node 1, 2 to 2. And if we don't have a cost, we give infinity. Here we've used 999. So this is our original costs. And then we update this matrix by using the for loops with the values I, J, and K, looking at each of the nodes in the matrix and seeing if we can find cheaper costs. So when we run this, you can see this is our final answer. This is the cheapest cost from each node, every node, to the other nodes in the network. Now, to make it even easier to understand, we can look at each step. So we've created a print statement to show where we've got a lower value, and also we're going to print out the matrix every time it gets updated. So if we run the code now, you can see that we have all of the matrices once any value is updated. So we can start off, we can see when we find a value. So here we can see at 3, 0. So in our third list, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 0, the first value, we can see that 5 is less than 999. So we can do this. We can update all of the values, the costs, update the matrix, and once we get through, we can update all the infinity costs because we can find cheaper costs. And then you will see mainly on the end of the first few lists and the last list, we've got some values like 988, which these costs can be reduced, as you see. And we go through the whole matrix of updating any costs which are lower than the cost in the current matrix. So we go through all of them until we come out with our final answer that has the correct costs, the minimal costs going from every node to every other node in the graph. So the code, very simple, just check the cost to see if we have a lower cost, then update it, and we use just three for loops. We apply that on this adjacency matrix, which is a list of lists, six lists, which we have six vertices, six nodes. Okay, so that's the Floyd Warshall algorithm. Don't forget, if you've liked this video, please click like, and if you haven't already, please subscribe.